So basically where the challenges are, we've got challenges for us, the operators. We had invested a lot in agent distribution networks, but right now most of those are empty because our primary use case was the cash out use case. We need to invest more as far as payment platforms and innovation around that area is concerned. We also have challenges for the channel partner users, which is predominantly our agents. Most of our agents are not realizing a business case as well because they were used to the cashing in and cashing out business. What we've tried to do to that effect was to give them more use cases. For instance, some of our agents are now selling prepaid tokens for Zeta to try and liquidate them, but still there's a challenge as far as cash is concerned. Then there's a challenge to the customer. There's lack of product knowledge. People were just used to using mobile money for cashing in and cashing out, but there's a whole lot more that they can do, such as paying off bills, using debit cards on point of sale machines and so forth. So there's still a gap as far as consumer awareness of the product is concerned, which at this point I can throw to the regulators. They can intervene as far as educating our consumers are concerned, is concerned. We've got a lot of untapped markets. Like I said previously, the growth that we are seeing, there's phenomenal growth that we've seen in the payments, in the digital payment space, but that growth really has been as a result of the crisis. There's an opportunity to really understand what our customers need. For instance, if we profile our customers, we need to give them a full ecosystem where they can access products from a supply perspective and from a demand perspective. So there's still an opportunity for payments space. As Telecell Zimbabwe, we've shifted our focus on the cash out business to payments space. We've come up with a voucher management system. This is a system which has been adopted by some NGOs to distribute aid. Whereas in the past they needed to distribute aid in the form of cash, now they are using vouchers. I'll give an example of a voucher. A voucher by an NGO can have cooking oil, seed, fertilizers and things like that. So there's an opportunity to disburse aid differently from the cash culture that we're used to. There's also an opportunity for banked customers to redeem, to make use of banking services, which is your bank to wallet transfers and wallet to bank transfers. For telecash, really it's the banking services that I've talked about and the merchant payments. Our merchant payments are two-phased. We've got the over-the-counter merchant payments, which is typically what you'd use in your rural areas where you're moving value from one phone to the other. Then there's the sophisticated ones, which is the use of the card. So we leverage on our relationship with ZimSwitch, which connects us with all the banks.